It's about a quarter after six, and time now for What's Trending. Caught in a funk between quarantine and depression, a Los Angeles comedian is charting a new path. Those who have spotted him, they can't wait for him to zoom by again. On a skateboard, he travels at the speed of traffic, about 30 miles per hour. And this masked Mandalorian, just like the Star Wars character, is on a mission of sorts. Only this man-child, as he calls himself, is armed with his sense of humor. Tim Bramer is a stand-up comedian who realized that he no longer needs a stage. Tim says when quarantine hit, he realized he may not be able to perform comedy for quite some time. And a friend of his told him, hey, the world is your stage. Go act on it. Bramer's appeal is picking up steam on the streets of L.A., but for this out-of-work comedian, the act is for himself just as much as his audience. He says for him, this is his therapy time during a tough time, and it's also a way for him to spread happiness. So that's fantastic that it's going both ways and helping him and anyone who sees him out on the streets. And first of all, I'm impressed with the speed of that skateboard. Second of all, that costume that he has created is wonderful. He says he created it on his own, and that it can play music, it can shoot fire out of it, and he looks great.
Wow, that's so cool. I think he did a really good job creating that costume. The mask is on point. And this story kind of reminds me of, you know, the dog face story that we talked about a few months back with the guy who just kind of went viral for skateboarding with cranberry juice. This is definitely a little bit more creative and maybe a little bit more work and thought went into it. But it just goes to show that, you know, the world is your stage in this digital age we live in. You know, put it out there for the world and see what you get back.
Yeah, that's all you really can do, especially now these days where, yeah, a lot of the usual places we gather are shut down, and yeah, fine arts, they're hurting right now, but this is one way to get a laugh for everybody out there. We definitely need it during this time.
Well, that's great. It's such a fun story, and maybe that Mandalorian could lend his jetpack to the guy in this next story. If you hope to live to 100 years old, get ready to add to that dream with this amazing story of how a vet is ringing in his new century. Charlie Montanaro celebrating his 100th birthday by jumping out of the sky because he says that's about all there is left to do in life. The World War II vet still drives and lives by himself, and he's sharp as ever. Charlie served in the Merchant Marine. In World War II, he and other merchant seamen were responsible for delivering war cargo. They were often attacked, and it wasn't until 1988 the Merchant Marine were recognized as veterans. His jump is 100 years in the making, an honor flight celebration of his service. Just like that, Charlie's sliding into 100 years young. He says that his first blast of air to the face was cold, but he loved it and he'd do it again. So, oh my goodness, that skydiving is one of those things I always said as a kid, I want to do that, I want to do that. And now, like, as I'm in my 20s, I feel like I don't know if I want to do it anymore. It kind of freaks me out. But seeing Charlie here do it kind of gives me a little inspiration and makes me feel like maybe I could muster up the courage to do it. What about you guys?
Yeah, I was the exact same. You know, all when I was younger, I thought it looked like the most amazing thing to do. But now that I'm older, and especially now that I have a child, I feel like maybe that should hold off for a little bit. But I think it is the most perfect way to celebrate a very special milestone. And I love that part about it.
Oh, without a doubt, it's perfect. And you know, Peter, when I had to go shoot a promo on me skiing, I kind of felt like it was kind of the same having to do it. I'm sure if I got asked to go skydiving, chances are probably would go for it again, even though never done it in my life. But we're going to keep this happy theme going here. With almost three quarters of a century of life under her belt, one Massachusetts woman decided to take on a new hobby. Mary Standish says she had a birdhouse that had fallen apart and she decided to make another one. She turned that single project into an at-home hobby. She takes pictures of people's homes and mimics them for birds. First, she draws up the plans and then carefully cuts the wood. Since her husband and daughter passed away, this helps to pass the time. Mary has been making these as gifts to give to friends. If others ask her to make one, she asks for a donation. She plans to give some of the money to Operation Comfort Warrior. It's a program near and dear to her heart, having served in the U.S. Air Force. The skill comes naturally to Standish. She says her father was a carpenter, and she took art classes in high school. So how about that? A good way to pass the time, and all for a good cause, too. We need to support those good causes, especially now.
Of course, yeah. It's just great to always come up with new hobbies and new ways to spend your time as you get older. And she's very talented. Did you guys see that? You know, she really, really captures those houses perfectly, and they're impressive.
Oh, they're so impressive, and I love that she found this like really unique way to do something. You know, that's already been done, but making these houses, or these little mini bird houses, such a great idea. And again, goes to show that you're never too late to try something new.